Greetings. I am Brother Spence. This blessed evening, so-called January the 6th, 2022. Rhetorically speaking. Now 2022. On this so-called evening, so-called Thursday evening, of so-called January 6th, 2022, we know that both Hebraically and more so Ethiopically, we have reached the eve of the true Christmas day, that true Ethiopian Christmas or Mass gathering of the true Christ, the true Christos of the Anointed, that is the true Mashiach or the true Messiah, also known as Christ, the Anointed, in the first Advent, the first Epiphany, the first sighting of baby Yeshua, baby Jesus Christos, the first sighting in the infamous nativity scene in that true Christmas spirit that fulfilled Christmas, or Christmas season, leading up to the eve of this day. So-called January 7th, 2022. Every year, the Gregorian and the Julian calendar line up to this day, Ethiopically, in parallel to the Julian calendar, and similar Ethiopic and Afro-Semitic roots. We have the true Ethiopian Christmas from Hanukkah or Hanukkah, that Maccabee spirit, revolutionary spirit of shining divine light, shining Jah light in the darkness, leading up to the true Ethiopian Christmas. Not commercial Christmas on so-called December 25th, although that is usually around the same true Christmas season. We don't deal, I and I don't deal with the commercial side of commercial Christmas. I and I don't deal with Nimrod sticks and Satan claws worship, Tammuz worship. So we still say Merry Christmas through Jah's grace. According to Father's will, we say Merry Christmas to those who say Merry Christmas around the so-called month of December and after. But the true Christmas day is the Ethiopian Christmas on this blessed evening. And then tomorrow of this year will be so-called Friday, January the 7th, 2022. Sad. Watching the news, all they talk about is the incident that took place this very time last year on so-called January 6th, the call to action, the so-called attack on the Capitol. The hardcore Trumpsters, the Trump mob, that infamous Trump mob that made the headlines this very time last year. We question how much of that was prescripted, how much of that still is prescripted. And all I hear about, besides Omicron spreading, people getting sick, and this winter storm, this vicious winter storm that's passing through on this evening to give I and I a white Christmas. Sigh. Infamous Bahana Selassie, a.k.a. Bob Marley and the Wailers. That is a young Bob Marley and the Wailers. Singing in ska or soul version, should I say a doo-wop, you know, soul version or a ska version of White Christmas, the infamous Christmas song. Because even mainstream Christmas songs are not all bad. You know, White Christmas is more of a Western Hemisphere, I don't want to say European, but more of a Western Hemisphere tradition in the original physical birth of Christ, taking place in the Middle East and parts of Africa, Arabia, even going back to ancient and modern day Egypt, would not have too many white Christmases in that region of the Middle East and parts of Africa. But over here we have the change of season, the winter season. And so tonight, despite traditions of man, we can sing I'm Dreaming of a White Christmas, the true Ethiopian Christmas, as we say in the Volam Har tongue, Melkam Genna, Melkam Ledet. So let's proceed. Back to the biblical studies, Salika. Back to the biblical studies of the book of Exodus, Shemot, second book of the Torah. We just began. And where we left off in the previous Torah portion reading from 2 weeks ago, we are now entering the third Torah portion reading. We have Shemot. Week before last was Vayera. Now we enter Bo. And these other two previous Torah portion readings will lead up to Beshalach. Beshalach to Exodus 13, verse 17, to chapter 17, verse 16. So as I connect the dots, hopefully, job willing, connect the dots in these next couple of videos regarding the first few chapters of the book of Exodus, if ones are interested in the Torah portion readings, if you feel that the Most High Jah, Yahweh, Jehovah, some pronounce Yahweh or Yahovah, whatever divine name of Hashem, whatever divine name of the Most High, Yahweh, Eloheinu, Jehovah, as the Allahayim or Allah, you know, Eloah, or the subjective name of Allah, whatever divine name you refer to as the Most High, the Omnipotent Creator. We have a Quran that speaks of in Surah 11:96 says we as the Allahayim or Ha'Elohim, the plural form of God and the angels. And we sent Moses, the great prophet, Musa or Moshe, in that original Hebrew pronunciation. It says in the Quran, in the Arabic scriptures, and we sent Moses with our clear signs and an authority manifest. So the great prophet Moses or Moshe says they sent Moses our clear signs and authority manifest unto Pharaoh and his chiefs, but they followed the command of Pharaoh, a mortal man, a godless man who was an idol worshiper. They followed the command of Pharaoh, and the command of Pharaoh was no right guide. In 98, it says he will go before his people on the day of judgment and lead them into the fire. So we have that now in the spiritual Egypt, this core of daughter Babylon. In these last of last days is very interesting because I chose to begin this time last year in the Torah portion Beshalach. That's not even the third or fourth reading of the book of Exodus. And it's interesting because after we come out of bondage, we come out of Mitzrayim, as we say Hebraically, we come out of bondage to be free. That first spiritual exodus in these renewed covenant times begins with accepting the ultimate truth of Yahweh's grace, Jehovah's grace, the ultimate truth of Jah's salvation in these renewed covenant times is through the Brit Hadashah, the renewed covenant, the basic good news gospel of Yahshua the Messiah, the good news gospel of what they call Jesus Christ, in connection with the true Christos, or the true Christ, Jesus, whose name is Yeshua, not Antichrist Jesus, because Antichrist Jesus will bring you back into Babylon, back into confusion, back into spiritual bondage. You're here to break free for true, as Rastafari say, true repatriation. And that first exodus must begin with the heart and the mind. That spiritual transition out of bondage, out of confusion. So this is why I began the weekly Torah portion reading studies. You can feel free to look up my channel, Brother J. Spence. Feel free to click on the video link and scroll down. You'll see 11 months ago, or almost a whole year ago, I put out a video titled Torah Portion Reading, Beshalach, Part 1 of 3, a three-part study, and then added the Haftarah extension of Shofatim, the Book of Judges, and took it back home with the Gospel according to Matithyahu, or St. Matthew. So, anyways, I would encourage ones to check out the selection of videos and tune in to the Torah portion readings. The Torah portion reading began the first few chapters of Exodus, the first chapter of Exodus 2 weeks ago. We have after Genesis, or better sheet, after the book of Genesis, we have Exodus or Shemot. So I do encourage everyone to stick with the Torah portion readings. But anyways, we shall continue going to the previous chapters leading up to Beshalach, I believe. Here's a little flashback.
Right, previous bit. Some say chalice. My bong was a little clogged up.
Didn't have my chalice.
Yeah, thanks and praises. Thanks and Isis, the Most High Yahweh. Yeah. Rastafari.
Aliyah Selassie. We have Beshalach.
Aliyah Selassie.
For a portion reading.
Aliyah Yeshua Ayah.
So.
Thanks and praise.
But leading up to that chapter, Beshalach. Leading up to chapter 13, Salika. So chapter 13, verse 17, we will cover the gaps between the first six chapters and leading up to chapter 13 in the book of Exodus. So stay tuned for this weekend. I've been very busy these past couple of weeks, these past several weeks. It's been constant work, 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 hustle, 6 days a week, catching up with family and other things, despite traditions of men. And playing music with my brethren. Other things in life that I do enjoy. It's all a part of job works, but I've been busy. So I will try to this coming Shabbat, this coming weekly Sabbath, here in a couple days, take time to go over these studies, fill in the gaps of the chapters between chapter 6 in the book of Exodus to chapter 13. Picking up in the weekly Torah portion study. So, until then, I would like to get in the spirit, that true Christmas spirit, the Mass, the true Christos, Jesus Christos, the Messiah. Shalom.